Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. If you love melody, please thumbs up this video. I'm about to go in depth on how to make melodies like top producers. And Palace is a really cool, humble person, I must say. And I like his products that he has as well. He has some merch coming out. I'll probably end up getting a hoodie or a shirt or something, whatever he comes out with. So shout out to Palace. He's known for his great melodies. And I'm sure he knows this one secret is that with melodies, modern melodies at least, the difference is that it's not about the notes that you're actually playing. It's about the effects you use on the notes that you're playing. That's what melody is about nowadays. Now, of course, there's a music theory aspect to it that underlies the whole melody, but it's the stuff you do to the melody using effects. So I'll show you what that means. Let's load up SAR. A lot of people overlook this plugin in FL Studio. And I went to keys, and this patch is called FG Redundancy. We'll probably change out the sound. I just need a good starter sound. Let's send this to mixer insert one from our channel rack. So the question is, where do you start? First, I like to use a high BPM because most trap beats are pretty high BPM, and you want to have it at a higher BPM because it creates a sub rhythm. Okay, so it's a little bit advanced, but since we're not making the full beat, it won't make sense until later anyway. So with melodies, where do you start? You just pick a key, pick whatever key sounds cool. I think that note sounds cool, so let's start here. And let's go to pattern mode. I have my snap to grid set to 1/2 beat. Okay, now what you want to do is simply split up chords. Now, if you understand chords and how we teach chords, you could use your chord codes. In this case, this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is a minor chord code. We go over all this stuff in our Music Theory Essentials course package at busyworksbeats.com/musictheoryessentials. But for now, I'm just going to draw out the notes for you. And another thing is people make everything the same length. When you're playing melodies in your head, all the notes are not the same length. You leave gaps. You're not doing that with your melodies in FL. Now we could even flip this to be, okay, this is A minor, this could be G major. Okay, because technically we were playing A minor 7 when we added that G. I don't want to get too music theory and ease on you. It's just pick notes to sound good, and most likely splitting up a chord will be your best bet. So what we're doing is going from A minor 7 into the chord for wherever we landed. So if it were inverted like this, I would say, okay, the last note, we're going to build a chord from that note and then just invert it down so it sounds more natural. So the next note here would be G, B, D, and let's count that out. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 would be F sharp. So let's try something different and go outside the key and go to F sharp. This may or may not sound cool. It depends on the context. But again, the theory here, the pattern that I'm using is this. So imagine me continuously building chords on top of each other. So the first chord is A minor 7. Second chord is G major 7, okay? And we're using the 7th and then making a chord from that. So that's the kind of pattern behind this. And to make it sound even cooler, we can go backwards, so we can invert it going the other way around. But let's build out the chord first from here. So this would be, let's do F sharp. Let's just count it out. Let's see if it sounds good as a minor or a major. So it's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, that sounds good as a minor. So what I'm going to do now is have these notes go downward. So I'm going to hit control down and flip these notes. So E is going to swap with A. And I'm going to create a little pause here. Okay, let's keep that as a note. And again, remember, we landed on E. That was our last note. This is getting a little complex because we're moving all the notes around. But again, here's what it looks like if we were to just draw it out in straight lines. The first chord is a minor seventh chord. Second chord is a major seventh chord. Third chord is a minor, let's see what this is, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, a minor seventh. And we're just making it sound cool by moving the notes around. So that's the technique to simplify it. But it's more complex once we start folding it down into different octaves and doing different things. And we teach all this in our Music Theory Essentials course package at busyworksbeats.com/musictheoryessentials. We teach this stuff from melodies to scales to modes to chords, scale degrees. We go over how to come up with chords, nomenclature, all that type of stuff. Okay, so let's figure out the chord, the seventh from E. What would that be? And again, it's just, does it sound good as a major or minor? Let's assume a minor. So that'd be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And again, the technique is we're going backwards in the notes. So I'm going to invert all the notes down an octave and then flip them. Let's try a major. Yeah, we did minor. Let's try a major. Let's pull these up one. Minor sounded the best. Okay, now let's space these out so they have a little bit of room to breathe. And then what I'm going to do is copy the same exact thing, but start on G instead of A. So that fits in that G. Now your melody is a moving thing. Now you can swap out the sound. Now some of these sounds aren't going to be the best. Let's do this one. Now let's go inside and take out some of the reverb effect if I could find it. Since I can't see the delay because my screen is so like tiny, I mean, not tiny, but so big, I think the delay might be at the bottom. I can't see it from here. So regardless of that little delay bounce, let's go to the mixer and here's how we can start morphing this sound. This is why I said don't get too tied into the actual sound. Let's open up halftime. You can get halftime under gross beat. The reason I use halftime is because it works better in my opinion. If you go to gross beat though, you can go to your presets and go to momentary, and then go to half speed. But it only does this for one bar. Now the trick is pulling back the mix level here. And that actually sounds really pleasant. So let's keep it on gross beat just to keep it FL Studio native. I'll let you download these project files for free. So thumbs up the video if you like that as well. Now I'll show you some really advanced stuff. Let's go to Fruity Delay 3 and pull back the dry level all the way, pull back feedback all the way, and pull down delay time and turn up your time modulation. This creates the pitch wobble effect. Now you might not want to use this too much, depending on the melody. But now your melody has its own bounce. Now we need some reverb in here, so let's add a reverb. Let's turn the reverb up, give it a nice decay curvature, add a little pre-delay, cut out the lows. I like to cut out the highs as well. Another trick is add all these effects before gross beat. That's another trick. Now here's a triple trick. Let's add this to the playlist, and now we're going to get pretty advanced. Let's duplicate this over. And how many bars we have? 16. So let's go to our mixer again and right click create automation clip for the halftime effect. Copy that initial value by right clicking, hit C, and then you can automate it on and off throughout the beat. So it's not just like one static value. And this will create a really unique experience. Let's go to play song mode. And they can have it come in and out. Let's kind of even it out so it's not too dramatic either way. Now, gross beat, you have to make sure you hit the stop button twice so it lines back up. Let's also do this with Fruity Delay 3, create an automation clip. Now here's the advanced part. You can create automation, but the thing about this is you want it to be a little bit more random so that it emulates a tape machine effect. So you can right click and change the type of curvature from point A to point B. Let's change this to a half sine, or actually let's change this to a staircase. And then just change the tension by left clicking on it, and you can see it creates a shape. And this will create like a phaser effect. Sometimes it sounds really cool, like a chorusing effect. It just depends. So just keep changing up the shapes. You don't have to do it this way. I like it this way because it's more random. Now the wave gets a little too random to where it sounds like it's messy. So that doesn't sound too creatively advancing. So that's the only waveform that I would suggest against, and maybe the pulse, unless you there's no way to even figure out where the middle point is. So I would use stairs, smooth stairs maybe. Let's see, smooth stairs. And again, the more effects you add, the greater it sounds. So for example, here's another effect, turning your dry level down on your reverb and using only reverb. But then the sound gets pushed all the way to the back. So that's one of those make or break type of effects. You could use filter modulation, filter movement. What else could you do to kind of spice it up? You could add delay, actual delay. My suggestion is you throw this before gross beat. And another trick is taking it off tempo sync and just using a random millisecond value. So it's a little bit off the grid. And it just throws it in a really vintage way. Let's mess with this reverb. Now here's where our sound started. Here's with effects. Let's swap out the sound just to show you how you can use this on any sound now. That sounds a little dark. Now we're getting all these weird sounds. Let's pull this octave up because bells are different. They're usually a higher octave. But I just want to show you how you can literally swap out the sound and get. Now certain sounds I would probably swap out the halftime effect. And just to show you how far you can take it, we can replace this with an even simpler synth called SimSynth. And like you would never use this, but you can actually run some presets through. Now here's a really, really advanced technique. You can go to your cogwheel and then slightly detune this so that it feels like it's different tuning. Now we can't get into everything about tuning, but 445 hertz is cool to play with, and 432 hertz tuning is cool to play with. And on top of this, you can add gross beat movement if you want. I don't think it needs it, but you can go to your time slot, your tan beige slot, and create single curves and give it more movement this way as well. Or you can do it the opposite way, make it swell everything. So it gives it that reverse feel, but it's not actually reversed. And again, you can use a mix level inside of Gross Beat with this knob here. It's left click. This is for the volume patterns. The green one's for the time pattern. So you can blend in the jumpiness of it. Now let's add some effects just to widen it out a bit. Let's use some Fruity Stereo Enhancer and use some Phase Offset. I wouldn't use this every single sound. And let's start playing with the tempo as well. And I'll just keep going through the stock sounds just to show you how it's all effects. Here's without the effects. Now, luckily, we have a cool melody. Let's speed up the tempo a bit. Here's the regular sound. Here's with our effects. And if you didn't like that phaser sound, you can always go back and just turn off delay 3. Let's add another delay 3. This is really going to make it the pitch sound confusing. Another cool thing you could do is try out the arpeggio. I forgot to mention this in the settings tab. Now this might be too fast of a BPM, but we could slow it down a little bit. Thank you. Now, just as a quick recap, here's without. So I just wanted to show you that melody is a lot more nowadays. It's not just play through melody anymore, it's effects melody. So you have to learn mixing and you have to learn music theory. And we have you covered with the Music Theory Essentials course package at busyworksbeats.com/Music Theory Essentials. I'll leave a link below. We're also updating our mixing course called the Mixing Academy. I'll leave a link below as well. There's a lot to learn, but thank you for watching today. There's a course called Melody Magic, which is included in the Music Theory Essentials course package, and this explains the new way of melody. It's not just playthrough style anymore. Thank you for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com. Don't forget to give the video a like and subscribe if you're new. It's busyworksbeats.com.